Researchers found that kids with ADHD often don't take their medication regularly. The study found that children with attention deficit disorder go off their medication on average 40% of the time, with kids from socially disadvantaged families most likely to be inconsistent. Here's Associate Professor Daryl Efron from the Murdoch Children's Research Institute. Hi, Daryl. So 40%, that's a surprisingly high number, isn't it? Why aren't kids taking their medication regularly?
Yeah, first of all, overall, this large Australian study found that about 3.6% of Australian children had ever been prescribed a medication to treat ADHD. So I think that's kind of reassuring. That's about the right level of proportion of kids that should be on medication. ADHD affects about 5% of kids and they don't all need medication. But as you say, it was a higher than expected rate of kids who are dropping off medication at some stage during the treatment, and it was on average 40%. And our study didn't examine the reasons why, but there's probably a whole range of factors contributing to this.
And can you name a few?
Well, you know, we know, as you say, that it was the more socially disadvantaged kids or kids from more socially disadvantaged families that were more likely to have gaps in their treatment. And we know that for many families, it is quite difficult to get to medical appointments, particularly with specialists, with factors involving, you know, getting access to appointments. Transport to appointments can be difficult for some families. And then there's costs involved, particularly in the private sector, which can be a barrier to access for some families as well.
And are these young kids that you looked at, what age group were they?
This was across the child and adolescent age group from 4 to 15 across five waves of data. So it was representative of large thousands of Australian children in all demographics and across that wide age range. So we think it's pretty a good representative picture of the pattern of medication use for these kids. And it really does show that we as professionals need to work harder to engage kids, to get their trust and their family's trust and keep them coming back for review for both the benefits and the side effects of medication, see if it's doing what it's supposed to be doing and they're tolerating it well.
Right. So what impact does taking medication sporadically have on outcomes?
Well, look, if medication's helpful, and in ADHD it is in 4 out of 5 kids, then it's best to stay on it consistently. It's not harmful to come off your medication or to have gaps. It's just like when you and I don't have our coffee in the morning. But for kids with ADHD, it's more than that, because they were prescribed in the first place because they're highly impulsive and they're inattentive and can't focus on their work, and it can affect their relationships and so on. So if they're coming on and off, they're likely to have erratic patterns of behaviour that's not going to be good for sustained learning, for sustained friendships and relationships. And you know, this medication helps kids with ADHD in all aspects of their functioning, and so it is best if they take it more or less consistently.
Is the diagnosis rate of ADHD in Australia going up?
We don't think it is going up. There's different methods used at different times to look at this. Overall, it went up a lot about 20 years ago, and we've only got a proxy measure of diagnosis, and that is the prescribing data that we've got. And as I said before, I think the number of kids on medication overall is about right. It's nowhere near the excesses that we sometimes see in the United States. And it's much higher than some of the, it's higher than some of the countries in Europe that hardly prescribe at all. And relative to how many kids have ADHD, I think 1 in 30 is about the right level overall. But our study shows that kids should be on the medication more consistently once it's been shown to be helpful.
Daryl Efron, thank you.
Pleasure. Thank you.